So Miyukato will start with the serves. Again, alternating serves every 2 points till it comes to deuce. Now this is very interesting. A slow spinny shot sets up a high killable ball, but it's not as easy as it looks despite that ball being very high. There's the power, one into the middle and then wide out to the wings. The top spin deep. Hanying, a very versatile chopper. Nice net recovery here in the kill shot with serious power from Kato. I thought as soon as it hit the net, she'd be done. This right here, she was going to swing. Look at that touch. Halfway through the swing, changes to a push. A lot of balls back in play from Hanying, but smart play when the topspin comes in. Oh, burned. Turned and burned. Steps around the backhand corner and leaves herself vulnerable on that wide forehand line. It's the first point I can recall seeing the strawberry out of Kato, trying to mix it up. Faint of heart. She makes it all the way through this. How many attacks from behind the table? Hanying. Top edge of the racket. It is game point for the defender, Hanying. Survives a quality push. Good touch from Miyukato to send it to deuce. Top spin comes in and it comes back faster. A bolder counterattack off the top spin coming in, and Miyukato with the first game in this best of seven. Trying to stay closer in this rally. Down the middle of the table, Hanying chopping still. Meaning you're able to generate a variety of spins. Stayed on the attack for a long time in this rally. Hanying trying to stay close to the table.
Seven, nine.
Deep to the corner, heavy top spin from Kato as the ball accelerates towards her opponent, finds the edge of the racket. Calmness works just one at a time, and heart racing to get through that one. After two game points were saved, you can imagine the stress on the strawberry farmer's side. But it's Miyukato who takes game number two by a narrow margin, 11-9. Starting off game three with the serves. It's very tough when the ball's out in front when it's shallow to lift it. You have been cured of asthma. This point right here, an endurance tester. Wow, if you survived that. Good angle here. Runaway with the score line now. She only needs this one here, 11-4, a dominant scoreline after two very narrowly won games by Miyu Kato. Oh, off the edge of the racket, Miyu Kato. Right back in off the top of the net, but down the line nonetheless. Oh, back edge of the table. A little bit of fortune here again for Han Ying.
He's
trying that out here, but it's always game of calculations, sort of deciding what risks are worth taking.
11-2.
A similar attempt, but this time around it is Han Ying, 11-2. Very low trajectory shot, risky. Just amazing. Miyu Kato hitting some of the fastest shots we've seen. Topspin comes in. Miyu Kato a bit more comfortable in this rally. The fast, flat backhand of Han Ying off the short pitch side of the racket, 11-5. Han Ying one game away from a spot in the women's singles final. Starting strong here as well. She stays close to the table. Out of frame, but not out of the point. Han Ying from way back.
Nine
points to one. Han Ying with the attack once again. Interesting, interesting. Six match points for Germany's Han Ying. But it is Han Ying 11-4. Four straight games from down 0-2 over the strawberry farmer Miyu Kato of Japan. And she has earned herself a place in the women's singles final.